afternoon. North have led all game, but they just can't shake off this determined double blue side. And Andrew Marks, more of the same we expect in this final quarter, but gee, you got to say the first goal is so very important, it is, but the way this game is seesawed about in terms of goals, I think there's a few chapters left to go.
Yeah, most definitely, John. This is going to be a really exciting last quarter. Every time North Adelaide have got that little bit far in front, Sturt have always come back with two or three goals to follow them up. So, look, the first goal is going to be important, but you could probably say the first five are going to be, because it's been a real arm wrestle, and I think it will continue to be that way.
And Phil Hurd, another goal to the Magpies at Alberton.
Absolutely. They have kicked 8-3 this quarter. As I'm calling it, they're home, the 40-40 rule. They're up by more than 40 points, and it is 29-minute gone of the third quarter. Port, 17-8, 110. South, 10-8, 68. That is 42 points the margin. As the crowd clears here, we've had a humdinger for a football game. It's gone back and forth. North have just had a goal or two lead all day. Can Sturt come from behind to steal the win and make it 6 in a row? Will the Roosters prevail at home? Your caller is John Nankerville.
It's going to be big Osborne and Craig, as it has been for most of the day in the ruck. Osborne won it down. McKenzie, though, shark for the Roosters. Kick to half forward. Bounce past Stevens. Harvey took it, but a handball off to McDonough. McDonough gets it back to Wilkie. His kick smothered. Coming through there, picking it up nicely, was Thring. His handball went straight to Sturt's Jonas, who handballed to a teammate who was immediately ridden into the ground. That player was Battersby. And we'll see a further ball up just inside the forward 50 arc for North Adelaide. They're kicking it to the north-eastern end in this final term as Stevens flicked out the handball to Jonas, to Crocker. A chance for Sturt to clear. Crocker chips up to Battersby at halfback. Battersby with some run down that outer wing. Does it nicely. Goes short. Unable to complete the mark there. Ground level. Sturt player is having a lot of trouble getting it out. And he's going to be pinged holding the ball. And that was Mark Evans, as Motlop will take the free at half-back now for North Adelaide. So Motlop chips to half-forward off the hands of Harvey. Sturt have the numbers again. Handball comes back there to Fraser Evans. High kick, high, wide and handsome. Out of bounds on the full on that outer wing. So Thring will get the free for North and the chance to put them back inside 50. We've gone just over a minute in this final term.
2 weeks ago, North, in a similar situation against the Crows, couldn't hold on. Let's see if they learn. And we're going to the same end as well, I should add, in the final quarter. As the kick comes in, with Schwartz taken high, umpire says no. In fact, holding the ball, and will be double blues free. It'll be interesting to see if North Adelaide have learnt some hard lessons from that Crows defeat on how to keep a lead and convert their opportunities in a final quarter. Right now the ball is with Sturt and the clearance from defence. It's on the wing on the outer side. Big fly, no one could take a mark. It's Bills, kicked forward by Wilson, only as far as McMahon. He's a centre wing, he's about to get tackled. They're working it through some handballs here to Greenslade. His hand pass under pressure to no one in particular, but Kirkwood,
oh, wow.
The pick-up, the spin move, the kick inside 50 to home was a piece of brilliance. Such good skills this late in a game under pressure. And, well, it deserves Hone to convert the opportunity. He's going to kick outside 50. Well, on 50, he's kicked 1 goal today. 8-5 for the season. A man they call Badge from the Mount Lofty Devils from 49. Kicks it high. It's going to be close. It's there. We've got ourselves a footy game. First goal of the final quarter to Sturt. They go to 9-7. That's 61. North Adelaide 9-8, 62. Special comments today with Andrew Marks.
That was an amazing work by Kirkwood. Then his ability to keep his feet after spinning out of that as well. He just kept his feet, kept balance, good disposal to find Hone. And also really good work from McMahon over in the outer side. Ability to stand tall in the tackle was really good to keep the ball moving forward for Sturt.
Umpire twirls at Skywood in the middle. One down, straight to Battersby for Sturt, who's tackled. And there'll be another ball up. 1 point the margin. Sturt have fought hard all day to stay in the contest. Now they're on the cusp of getting their first lead of the day. Swores tackled by Osborne. Umpire's watching. Is he going to ping him? He is. And Osborne will be rewarded with a free. Kirkwood running by, ignored that. Instead, went to Voigt. Voigt's kick long to 50. Off hands of the charging Beard, picking it up. Tone kicked the last goal. Can he kick another one to put Sturt in front? Just away to the left. Scores level. 4 minutes gone in this last quarter. It's 9-8-62 apiece. The behind Tahone has levelled the scores. And North to bring it back in.
They brought it back in. Roosters have some numbers. Motlop will run off defensive 50. Kicks it down the wing. A little bit too high for Ryswick. Harvey at ground level can't do it. Tries to tap it on to Craig. Doing well there was Riley just to stop it, and it spills towards out of bounds. Players wanting free kicks. Umpire saying... Actually, umpires are in conference. It is a throw-in. You're right, John Nankerville. Sturt have not led. Scores have been tied, well, three times if you want to be pedantic, start of the game, and twice during it. But the Double Blues have not led thus far in this contest. As Shannon has it, he's brought to ground by Battersby. Will be another stoppage.
Can I just mention Geordie McKenzie's work for North Adelaide? His inside work is just really good.
He often doesn't get a mention from us, just the hard work inside.
There he is again,
laying
that tackle. Yeah.
Comes in and lays another tackle. And that actually will be McKenzie's ninth tackle. Just to back up your thoughts there, Andrew. We're on pretty much true centre wing. Five and a half gone. Osborne the tap. This time Riley lays a tackle. This time there's another stoppage. We've gone nowhere in about the last 45 seconds. Five and a half gone. North 9-8-62. Sturt 9-8-62.
James Craig thumped it down. Wilkie couldn't pick it up. Riley was good to Crocker, who shows a clean pair of heels. Kicks towards 50. And Hone takes a good mark. Diving. He gets it at centre half forward. Too far out to score. He's up immediately. Looking for an option inside 50. Bouncing football. Sturt player infringed on the lead was Mark Evans. Clisby the infringer. So Mark Evans will have a chance to put Sturt in front for the first time this afternoon. 6 minutes into this last quarter. Mark Evans, it was one goal this afternoon for the Double Blues, can put his adopted team, after starting his career with the Redlegs, in front. He'll be kicking from 40 out, straight in front. Mark Evans has kicked a goal. Sturt by 6 points, their first lead of the game. They go to 10-8-68, North 9-8-62. Evans gets his second. We've gone 7 minutes in this fourth quarter, and Andrew marks a battle for persistence for the Blues. They hit the front.
Yeah, certainly has been, and Evans is one of the straightest kicks in the SANFL, I believe. He's a good player to have on the end of it. But a really exciting 5 minutes by Josh Hone. He's been in everything. He's had a shot on goal and then got a point. And just that, he was involved in that little play there. So a real dangerous player at the moment for Sturt.
17 goals, six on the season, Andrew. So you're right about the straight kicking. As Osborne to Riley, it looks like the Double Blues have come out of the final quarter huddle with a bit more bounce about them and the rub of the umpire's green, so to speak, as it's going to be with Brodie Martin. He's got the free for over the shoulder. He's in the centre square at the moment. Goes with a long kick towards that 50-metre arc. Beard leading, couldn't take it. Motlop got the hand pass. And now they're away, the Roosters, down the centre wing. Ryswick couldn't take the mark. He's got to play on. Couldn't get the hand pass away, the open player. Sturt have him corralled. He needs some help. He gets it from Liston. Liston from half forward. Kick around the body inside forward 50. Who's there in red? There ain't no one. It's just Kirkwood. Kirkwood's kick across could put Wilson under pressure. Managed to get the hand pass away. Now they're moving it across field to Wildman, who kicked the key goal earlier. Wildman goes downfield, finds McMahon. Move up forward's been pretty good. From half forward. Now looking out there for Evans. In the end, it is Anderson, the former Double Blue, who spoils it momentarily. Oh. But it's a Sturt free kick, and John, they're about to tear down the grandstand.
It's going the way of Evans. He's at 50. North fans not happy as Evans goes in short. Beard spoiled, but a handball out back to Evans, who handballs straight to Clisby. North under siege at the moment, but they may clear here as McDonough to Virgin. Now Thring kicks out towards that outer wing. Evans up, Barnes with him, off hands, out of bounds. Score check, Sturt 10-8-68, North 9-8-62. 9 minutes gone, final quarter. This lead is Sturt's first lead of the game. And at the moment, their tails are up, but still plenty of footy left in this contest as Osborne slaps it down. Comes the way of Riley. Handballs backwards to go forwards. Big long kick there from Wilson back towards the forward 50 arc for Sturt. Beard completes a very nice mark. Hands off immediately there to Evans. Evans kick to the goal square. McMahon lets it bounce, and it bounces through. Evans gets his third. Sturt get their 11th. They're out to a 12-point lead. 9.5 gone in this fourth quarter. And Sturt all of a sudden looking like winners, Andrew Marks.
Yeah, since that little effort from Kirkwood where he ran, you know, did that backspin and, and got out, they've seemed to be get a lot of confidence from that. And that was a really good kick from Evans. But notice too that Beard clunked that, and we spoke about that at three-quarter time. Which forward is going to actually clunk them? And Beard good that got that one. The players were then able to spread it around from him. Evans was in the right spot and a good finish.
12 points the margin. Sturt have kicked four goals this quarter for mine as it comes to three. They've taken the lead by two, nonetheless. Then they've got the clearance, Battersby. But it's picked up by Ryswick. What can the veteran do with the footy? He finds Virgin in between two Sturt players. He's marked at centre wing, out of side. Virgin with a short kick downfield finds an open player in Motlop, who went down, got tackled, holding the ball. No time to check who made the tackle because Sturt are playing on. They're attacking, attacking, attacking. The kick for Beard. Anderson got it away from him. Comes back to Ryswick. He's under pressure. Quick hand passes. One through to Virgin. Now it's with Tahana in the middle. He's in the T-saucer. He just looks for the goals and goes long. Long looking for Barnes. Big thumb from behind by Gilfroy. He's got a teammate there in Anderson. He pumps it onto Stevens. Stevens now looking for Lynott. And the double blues will clear out of defence, but this one is high. And I reckon that it's going to lob in play. Stayed in bounds. Wynn kept it in. It's on to Voigt. Voigt kicked it inside 50. Back of the pack. It's inside Sturt's forward 50 at the moment. In the end, they draw the player. The Roosters. Cameron Craig got the ball at his feet. McMahon comes in. Can Sturt make use of the error? Was it home leg? Umpire says play on. He says ball. And it'll be John, a relieving free kick. A lot of North Adelaide fans take a sigh of relief.
They do indeed, as Ryswick, the tackler, will take the free deep in defence.
Got Virgin out on the other side.
And that's where he's headed. Out towards Virgin underneath the time clock, which shows nearly 12 minutes gone in this fourth quarter. Sturt by 12 points after trailing all day, taking the lead early in this term. They've kicked back-to-back goals as McDonough marks the Virgin kick at half-back. Kicked the goal in the first term, McDonough. On this occasion, he'll kick a high ball towards half-forward. Barnes trapped in the middle, knocked it down. Tierley couldn't run onto it. Jonas grabbed it for Sturt, kicked it back towards that outer wing where Wildman, the young man, who just his second SANFL game, who kicked his first goal today in SANFL League Company, took the mark and kicks to Martin, who's got it in the middle of Prospect Oval. He's got McMahon, who's been one of Sturt's best, whether down back or up forward. McMahon's kick inside 50. Beard, Anderson there. Grove coming in. Beard trying to get the handball out. In the end, he's taken over the line and there'll be a throw-in. Left forward pocket for the Double Blues side. 13 gone, final term. Another goal here to Sturt. Wouldn't be game over, but gee, that'd be hard to catch. As Voigt in the ruck, wins it down. Liston got a handball to Grove. Clisby gets it back to Ryswick. Ryswick measures his kick, but it's going to lob in the arms of Wilson for Sturt. He's kicked two today already. He's not beyond his distance here, Wilson. A long kick, a strong kick. Is it an accurate one? No, across the face, a behind. Sturt 11.975, North 9.862, 13.5 gone, final term.
North are going to go right up the guts, but only as far as a double blue jumper. That was Crocker. Onto Fraser Evans, who's forward of centre on a rare movement. He's gone forward up and found a mark to McMahon. He's marked in front of the time clock. 14 gone, and we'll have the shot. This quarter, Sturt have kicked 3 goals, 2. North Adelaide have kicked 0.0 in this final quarter. Scoreless. 13 points the margin. McMahon from the boundary. Sizes up the goal. Wants the wind to take it back. He has slotted it. A great goal from a difficult position. Sturt have their 12th. Their rampage is on. 12-9-81, North 9-8-62. You're on 107.9 where the SANFL, the SANFL, comes to life.
Your business needs good people, and good people come from ATEC.
He's been close Adelaide to best on ground.
ATEC can provide your business with the best apprentice employment solutions in trades, from toolmaking to electricians to welders. In fact, whatever trade you need, ATEC have the simplest apprentice hire arrangements and the best apprentices to make your business the best it can be.
20 points behind at one stage.
Meet station sponsor ATEC at atec.asn.au and click on the button for employers. ATEC. The best people for the best apprentices.
Back here at Prospect, Sturt going forward again. They've been dominant in this final quarter. They were trailing by 7 points at three-quarter time. They now lead this contest by 18. And we've gone 15 minutes in the fourth quarter. As we will see a boundary throw-in. Right half forward for the double blues. As Evans, who had the ball, Mark Evans kicked. Came off hands and went out of bounds. Is in the ruck. One down by Craig, but slaps it straight to Battersby. He's getting busy for Sturt, as are a lot of his teammates. His kick, though, lands in the arms of Anderson. As Phil Herdon pointed out before, a former double blue. Also played with Carlton in the AFL. As his kick off hands, taken by McMahon, gave to Leanett. Handballed forward. Greenslade trapped it nicely. Spins around, kicks inside. 50. And it's a mark to Voigt for the double blues. The big man came steaming out of full forward and has taken the grab. Henry Voigt, he'll be about 25 out, pretty much straight in front when he kicks it. 16 gone in this final quarter. And if he nails this, it'll just about be all she wrote for the Roosters this afternoon. So Voigt, 25 out, straight in front to put Sturt in the lead by 4 goals. He's missed, away to the left. 16 and a half gone. North breathe a sigh of relief. 12-10-82, that's Sturt. North 9-8-62. 20 points is the lead.
Yep, miss from the man they call the Big V. We'll see 22 of them next week in the state game, 1 o'clock next Sunday. Make sure you join us. But from the kick in, it's come back to the double blues to Battersby. 60 out, goes across field to Martin, who dropped what he should have taken. He runs to 48, unloads the kick. It's going along with the distance. He stopped it. The wind's taken it. I'll tell you what, Sturt fans, do you believe? Because these double blues do. They go on now to 13-10. That's 88. North 9-8-62, a game high. 26-point margin.
Yeah, really good work by Battersby across half forward there to make sure that the ball stayed in their forward 50. And then he also was able to look sideways to see a free Martin who, although he spilled the mark, still had enough time to get in there and finish really well. And Sturt's last quarter has been really, really something special to watch.
This is the mark of a good team, what Sturt are doing. They trailed for 3 quarters. North played very well, but Sturt kept in touch. They kept hanging in there. And now they're coming home strongly, and they lead by what is a game-high 25 points as we approach time on in this final quarter. It was back in the middle. Craig won it down for North to McKenzie to Shannon. His kick didn't go far. Knocked down by Crocker. Swars took it for the Roosters. Got a handball out. Ryswick tackled. Ball jarred free. Pack forms. Umpire says my ball. Centre-half forward for North Adelaide, who are still scoreless in this fourth quarter. 9-8 their score. Sturt 13-10. As 26 points the lead to the Double Blues, and we'll see a ball up again, 55 out from North's goal. 18 and a half gone, final quarter. If they get any chance at all, North, they need a goal and they need it now. Shannon, high kick from the restart, back inside 50. Riley there, Crocker's got it, pressured by Tierley. Ball spills free, high kick from McKenzie. Liston there, Barnes as well, goes past all of them and out of bounds for, was off hands though, so it will be a throw in. Right forward pocket for the Roosters. Sturt by 26 points. We've gone 19 minutes.
Score update we'll give you from Alberton. South have kicked the first two goals of the final quarter, 11 minutes gone. The margin is 31 points in favour of the Magpies. As Barnes with the tap, what can Hender do? He's under pressure. Didn't take possession, was sat upon, but no free given. Spills to Motlop. Motlop with a high kick. Could do anything. Goals. Could go anywhere. It's gone through the goals. Motlop, he's kicked two goals and they've both been of quality. North Adelaide finally get a major in the final quarter. That'll make it 10-8-68. Sturt 13-10-88. Brings that margin back to 20 points.
Yeah, they're probably, that was a really handy goal because it probably keeps them in it. And with a little bit of belief here, there's probably a little bit of, you know, time still there for North Adelaide to give this a go. And Marlon Motlop's played quite really well today. And in front of goals, he finishes very well.
Well, one more or back-to-back goals here. You feel the North fans would make some noise. And suddenly it's a very interesting final 5 or so minutes. Craig won it down. Riley, though, took it for Sturt, scrubbed it out towards the wing. Shannon coming through for North, couldn't pick it up. Martin could for Sturt, went to ground. Handball back to Craig, to Motlop. Now McKenzie takes it for North, kicks towards the lead of Harvey, knocked away from him. Page was good for Sturt, cleaning up and finding Battersby at half-back. Battersby chips to the run of Crocker. He wants to play on, Hender coming in. Crocker's kick, not great, but it will ricochet towards Stevens, who kicks towards half forward. Unable to complete the mark, Greenslade, but he had the presence of mind to knock it on to Crocker. Tackle as he kicked, dribbled up towards 50. Spina picked it up, gave to Hender, to McKenzie, who goes short to Liston. He's at half back for North. What can they work here as it's marked by Clisby? Handball's over the top to Tahana. He's legged surely there by Riley. And he will get the free kick on this member's wing, Steve Tahana. Want to keep it moving quickly. We've gone 21 minutes in this fourth quarter. North trailing by 20 points after they led for the first three quarters. Guilfoy off hands. Got a handball out there towards Jonas. Lean it. And now Guilfoy again. He's kicked through the hands of Evans, but he was over the line, out on bounds on the full. North will get the free kick, the relieving free kick through three.
Just to add to the challenge for the Roosters, the reins are here. Just to add a little bit more slippiness, the kick. Well, Ryswick's trying to run himself around in a semicircle, does well to get the kick away. Only problem was there was not a red jersey in sight. And ended up being an easy mark for Fraser Evans. He's happy to slow it down. 22 minutes gone, 20 points the margin. Wet, slippery conditions here at Prospect. The kick looking out there for Battersby, who's marked on the outer side. He's got a good runner. And that should be Stevens, who with a bit of a juggle, takes the mark on centre wing. Double Blues doing well to keep possession, deny the Double Blues. This kick over the head of its intended recipients. McMahon, hasn't he set up some forward movements? To Kirkwood, who probably had the play of the day. His kick, though, only as far as McKenzie, whose kick was smothered. Spills now to Kirkwood. Kirkwood inside, 50. Taken by Mark Evans, who did he play on and miss everything? Yes, he did. Out of bounds on the full. North Adelaide footy. And they're not waiting around. Long kick down the outer side.
Almost 23 minutes gone in this final quarter. The kick from the Roosters. Off hands, out of bounds. At half back for North. Half forward for Sturt. The Double Blues kicking to the south western end. As we see the Brollies up there on the outer side in the terraces. Umpire swings it back into play. Sturt through Riley, tackled, going nowhere. And there'll be a ball up. Sturt will be happy to milk the seconds down. They know they've got a commanding lead of 20 points and there isn't a whole lot of time left. McKenzie trying to find Motlop with the handball. Sturt player came up with it in the end. Motlop tackled him. Ball came out the back. It's rolled out the back. And again, we see a further ball up. 60 out from Sturt's goal. Looking like they're going to win their sixth straight, the Double Blues. Have not lost since round one when the Eagles beat them. There's Martin at the bottom of this pack. I thought for a minute the umpire was going to say holding the ball, but no. He crosses himself and says, my ball, as he throws it up. Still at half forward for Sturt. McKenzie had it, lost it, tackled when he didn't have it. Advantage play on. Kick from Clisby, a long, strong one inside defensive 50, but a great mark going back there by Fraser Evans, saving the day for Sturt. 24 and a half gone fourth quarter. Sturt by 20 points. They look home.
They do indeed. And with the win and South's imminent loss, they'll be tied with the Panthers at the top of the table at the state game break. And I think we'll give you the ladder officially at game's end. But I think they're ahead on percentage as well, as Jonas has it, halfback. Sturt have decided if North don't have the ball, they can't score. And if no one's scoring, Sturt are winning. As they've gone to McMahon, half back flank, back pocket, front of the Pirates, the cricket club. 25 minutes almost gone of this final quarter. Looking for Hone. Wasn't he good in that little purple patch at the start of the final quarter? On to Wilson. He's got a runner. Here comes the kick down the centre wing. Looking in the Martin direction over his head. Beard came and created the contest. Couldn't take the mark. It spills and there's a Rooster player who's down. And is not getting up at the moment. And
is it Spina?
And that would be a shame if it was, because he's been really solid for most of the day. There'll be a stoppage in play. Might give a quick score update from Alberton, where it is the Magpies are on the verge of a win. It is Port Adelaide, 18-11, 119 with a shot on goal to come. South 12-10-82. The margin as it stands now 37 points. And in fact, they've lost the shot on goal that's been turned over for South to clear.
It is Spina down there. He's all right. He's getting up onto his haunches now. He's in the hands of the North Adelaide trainers. He's a bit sore and sorry, but he's okay. He's up and walking, which is pleasing to see. What a great way for him to end the day. He's played so well for North.
But just putting his body in line, yeah. You know, that player to try and spoil it. It was a really good effort. Coaches love that stuff.
26 disposals, 6 marks, 4 tackles.
As he heads from the field, I don't think he'll see any further party one. He's not even going to go through the interchange gates. Certainly better to be safe than sorry. As coming on for the Roosters, Cameron Craig, we will have a restart with a boundary thrown at the arc of 50. Sturt will win their 6th straight game as Osborne in front palms this one down, coming through Clisby, bangs it on the boot back to this member's wing, getting up high, knocking it down in the direction of Harvey. That was Wilkie knocking it down. Harvey's handball went to Wilson, slung around, got it to Kirkwood, went backwards to Page. Page will go short and find Battersby. Battersby has it at half-back for Sturt. He chips it inside defensive, 50 to Guilfoy again. As Phil Herden said, Sturt content to play keepies off and tick down the clock. Stevens has it, he chips to Fraser Evans, who's between right half-back and this grandstand centre wing, north-eastern end of the ground. It's Sturt 13-10-88, North 10-8-68. Big kick from Evans, back towards the wing. Osborne was up, off hands. Greenslade took it, tackled. Kirkwood in there applying the pressure. Handball came out from Tierley for North. Couldn't find a target, and there it is. The fourth quarter comes to an end. The game comes to an end. And it is a victory to Sturt, 13-10-88. North 10-8-68, a 20-point win to the Double Blues. After trailing until the early stages of this final quarter, Sturt have got up and won by 20 points to win their 6th game in a row and move into equal top with the Panthers. Just looking at the goal scorers for the two sides, Three goals each for Sturt to Beard and Evans. That's Mark Evans. Beard kicked all of his goals in the first half. Mark Evans, all of his in the second half. Two goals each then to Hone, who was very good in that second half, particularly that fourth quarter. And two goals to Wilson. And then single goals to Martin, McMahon and Wildman, which was Wildman's first goal in SANFL League colours for North Adelaide. Barnes kicked three, all of them in the first half. Two to Motlop, and then singles to McDonough, Hender, Shannon, Ryswick and Swars, rounding out the goal scorers for the two sides. Very dark here at Prospect. They haven't put the lights on yet.